paradise called the High Nelson Riddle and his orchestra are very, very special guests.
Cesar Romero.
Rosemary Clooney.
From out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make, so please keep the spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? All this your heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love from me. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love. Don't take your love from me.
Class dismissed.
How about me, teacher? You promised if I was real good, I could stay after school.
And so you may, Caesar, or this may be the shortest half hour in the history of television. Besides, I'm anxious to see Cesar Romero, Hollywood's master of intrigue and danger, in a musical like ours.
Well, me too. You know, it's a pleasure to appear in a show where I'm not a sinister character in a trench coat or a gigolo in a rented tuxedo.
Oh, I know just how you feel. Our vignette tonight is just about as far away as you can get from my usual role of the girl next door. And you'll be able to see this drastic departure from typecasting right after a brief message on behalf of our host.
In days of old, beside the Nile, a famous queen there dwelt. Her clothes were few, but full of style, her figure slim and svelte. On every man that wandered by, she pulled the feet of their eye. And everyone observed with awe that her work was swift. But never wrong.
I'd be like Cleopatra if I could have my way. Each man she met, she went and kissed, and she dozens on her waiting list. I wish that I had lived there beside the pyramid. For a girl today don't get the score that Cleopatra did.
Mm-hmm.
Darling Cleopatra was always on the spot.
She gave those poor Egyptian kings something else to watch beside the Sphinx.
Mark Anthony admitted that what first made him skid
was the wibbly wobbly wibbly dance that Cleopatra did.
Not me.
It was the wibbly wobbly wibbly dance that Cleopatra did.
Are you really Cleopatra, Queen of the Nile?
Sure, but you can call me Cleo.
Oh, thanks, Cleo. I'm General Brutus, and this is Claudius.
And I'm Cautious.
That's Cassius.
Cassius, Cautious, I'm yellow.
And who is this handsome one over here?
I'm Mark Anthony. You know, from the song we just sang.
Oh, yeah. I'll get back to you later. Meanwhile, back at the Nile, where is your great leader, Caesar?
Did someone call?
Hail Caesar! Hail Caesar! Hail Caesar!
You can hail all you want to, but around here, I reign.
Yeah. I'm kind of sorry I talked you into saying that.
You're sorry. How do you think I feel?
Smooth.
Mark Anthony, you forget where you are?
No, but for a minute there, I forgot where you were, sire.
Well, watch that. If there's any hand-holding to be done, Caesar will do it.
You're so masterful. May I call you Julius?
Well, you can call me anything you like, just so long as you call me. Well, what are you waiting for? Don't you know there's a war going on? Go out and collect souvenirs. Carve your initials on pyramids. Act like soldiers. I gotta keep my eye on that boy.
He took the words right out of my mouth.
Cleopatra, you baffle me. Half queen, half child. What sort of person are you anyway?
I'm just a little girl who's looking for a little boy, who's looking for a girl to love. Tell me, please, where can he be, the loving he who'll bring to me the harmony I'm dreaming of. It'll be goodbye, I know, to my tale of woe, when he says hello. So I'm just a little girl who's looking for a little boy, who's looking for a girl to love. It'll be goodbye, I know, to my tale of woe, when he says hello. So I'm just a little girl who's looking for a little boy, who's looking for a girl.
Very nice, very nice. Ah, look, Cleo, your army doesn't stand a chance against my Roman legions. Why don't you give up and join us?
Me, Cleopatra, give up and join the Foreign Legion? Never. Besides, they don't let girls into the Foreign Legion.
The squares. Well, Cleo, you could do worse than throw in with me. After all, I'm not only the undefeated emperor of the Roman Empire, I'm kind of cute, too.
I know. But we don't even speak the same language.
So what? I could teach a Latin just like that.
Well, if you can, you're better than my high school teacher, Miss Blodgett.
Come on, Cleo. Translate everything after me.
Omnes Gallia in tres partes divisa est.
I'm learning my Latin, and I'm passing the test. That means that all of Gaul's divided in parts of three. I'm learning my Latin, get a load of me.
Amavi,
I have loved.
Amavisti,
thou hast loved.
Amavit,
he has loved.
Amavimus,
we have loved.
Amaveris,
thou mayest.
Amavisis,
thou might. Is my conjugating up to par?
Your verbs are really quite irregular.
Veni, vidi, vici, as they used to say in Gaul. I'm learning my Latin, and I'm having a ball. I have loved.
Amavisti,
thou hast loved.
Amavit,
he has loved.
Amavimus,
we have loved.
Amaveris,
thou mayst.
Amavisis,
thou mightst. Is my conjugating up to par?
Your verbs are really quite irregular.
Veni, vidi, vici, as they used to say in Gaul.
She's learning her Latin, and she's having a ball.
We're learning our Latin, and we're having a ball.
Do you suppose history books will ever recover from our Cleopatra and Caesar effort?
I'm not even sure I'll recover.
Oh, come on now. The way you were rumbling all over the place. You know, if it wasn't for your hair... Yeah.
What about my hair?
Oh, prematurely gray.
Oh, but it's not. I'm prematurely old.
Young man, while I go over and join Bob Morse for the number you requested, would you give us a brief introduction?
I'd love to, Rosemary.
Thank you.
This duet is part of George Gershwin's great American opera, Porgy and Bess. Such an integral part, it's rarely performed as a separate number. After you hear what an effective treatment Rosemary and Bob give it, maybe all that will change. Here then is Bess, You Is My Woman.
Never going nowhere,
less you shares the fun. There's no wrinkle on my brow, no how, but I ain't going, you hear me say, if you ain't going, with you I'm staying. Porgy eyes, your woman now. Eyes, yours forever. Morning time and evening time and summertime and winter time.
Morning time and evening time. Summertime and wintertime. Best you've got your man.
For best you is my woman now. Never going nowhere, less you shares the fun.
Now and forever,
there's no mind those when my brow.
You got your porgy,
no
loves your porgy,
but I. If you ain't going, with you I'm staying. Porgy eyes, your woman now. Eyes, yours forever. Morning time and evening time and summer time and winter time.
Morning time and evening time and summer time and winter time.
Oh, my Porgy, my man Porgy, from this minute I'm telling you. I keep this vow.
Oh, my Bessie,
eyes your woman. No.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Oh, can we have Bob back? We need him in our next number.
Why, sure. What is all this, Clarky?
Maysville Mining and Copper's up an eighth.
No. It looks as if the boys are developing interests outside of singing. You ready? We now take you to the brokerage firm of Burroughs, Strassen, Perling, and Morse.
Of the worry that money brings, just a little filthy lucre buys a lot of things, and I could take you to places you'd like to go, but outside of that I've no use for dough. It's the root of all evil, of strife and upheaval, but I'm certain, honey, that life could be sunny with plenty of money and you. Money, money,
money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money, money. Could take you to places you'd like to go, but outside of that I'm no use for dough. It's the root of all evil, of strife and upheaval. But I'm certain, honey, that life could be sunny with plenty of money and you.
Thank you, boys. And thank you, too, Caesar, for being such a good sport. Isn't it strange how many times a day we find ourselves saying thank you to someone? Some person who has done something kind or thoughtful or generous for us. And yet, with the exception of one Thursday each fall, how rarely do we remember to give thanks to the one who is the giver of all good? Shouldn't each day be a day of giving thanks? We all have so much for which to be grateful. This is from the book of Psalms. I will praise the name of God with a song and will magnify him with thanksgiving.
Bless this house, O Lord, we pray. Make it safe by night and day. Bless these walls, so firm and stout, keeping warmth and trouble out. Bless the roof and chimneys tall, let thy peace lie over all. Bless this door, that it may prove ever open to joy and love. Bless these windows shining bright, letting in God's heavenly light. Bless the heart ablazing there, with smoke ascending like a prayer. Bless the folk who dwell within, keep them pure and free from sin. Bless us all that we may be, fit, O Lord, to dwell with thee.
Well, Caesar, that's our show. Did you like it?
Oh, I loved it. Especially our duet.
Gee, you know, I wish I could rumba the way that you do.
Are you kidding? Well, I could teach you to rumba just like that. Come on, Rosemary. I know a ballroom where we can still get in a couple of hours of rumbling.
Oh, well, gee, I'm sorry. I really can't. I have a sister who'd love to go rumbing with you.
Oh, fine. She's half as cute as you are.
Oh, she's much cuter. Of course, she's only 11 years old.
Yeah. Oh, well, in that case, tell her I'll call her at 8:30 sharp in about 9 years. Good night, Rosemary.
Good night, Caesar. Thank you. And thanks to all of you for being with us tonight. Till the next time, then, good night, everyone.
Rosemary, do 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 do